Christmas story didn't start here with a baby in a manger. It started there with a plan and a word. In the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He existed in the beginning with God. God created everything through him, and nothing was created except through him. The Word gave life to everything that was created, and his life brought light to everyone. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it.
Look, son, they distract themselves with the things of earth, with creation, not their creator.
Yes, I see, Father. They don't understand. They don't understand that only you can fill the void. Only you complete them. Only your love can make them truly happy.
They are so lost. We must show them.
Yes.
It will mean the ultimate sacrifice. It will mean leaving here. You would go to them, become like them, to love them and heal them and show them the way. If not, they can never truly know our love or be complete. And they could never be here with me. And son, I have to have them here with me someday. I just have to. I want that more than anything.
I will do it, Father. I will go.
It won't be easy, son.
I will go.
You will feel their pain and temptation.
I will do it.
They won't love you the way I do.
No one can love me the way you do, Father.
They will hurt you repeatedly.
Yes, Father.
They will even kill you, and you will bear their guilt and shame.
Yes, but I have to go. Your love for them is so great, and your love for them is in me too. I also love them. I must go to them.
I would give everything else for even one of them to be here with me.
I will go, Father.
Yes, you will go.
How shall I show them our perfect love in their world?
I will tell you when the time comes, son. You will not be alone. I will be with you until it is time for you to complete the sacrifice. But one thing, son, you will have to face death alone. For a short time, we will be completely separated. But then you will raise up to be with me again.
Is it the only way?
Yes, it is the only way.
Then your will be done, Father. Father, what is required of them to return here with me?
Only to accept and receive your sacrifice on their behalf.
Only that?
Son, they are not capable of earning it. They must just believe and receive our love, our sacrifice in their place. And son, I want nothing from them but their love.
Their flawed, imperfect love?
Ha! I can't wait, son. I can't wait.
What perfect love you have, Father, that even their feeble attempts to love you could cause your heart to erupt with joy.
You understand, son.
Yes, I do, Father. So I will go.
Son?
Yes, Father.
While you are there, my heart will ache for you to be here the way it now aches for them.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believed in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. So the Word became human and made his home amongst us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's one and only Son.
Hey, Hezekiah.
Oh, hi, Zariah.
Hey, what's all the murmuring about?
Oh, you haven't heard.
The word's leaving. The Son is leaving to go where?
Oh, I heard he's going down there.
Down there? Down there? Well, why would he go down there? Have you been down there lately? It's a mess.
Yeah, but not only that, he's going down there to be one of them.
No.
Yeah. Apparently, Gabriel's on his way right now to go tell some human woman she's going to have a son. It's going to be him.
He's going to be human? But really? I mean, how is he going to be human? And why is he going to be human?
Hold on. That's not all. He's also going down there to be Emmanuel.
Emmanuel? But they won't understand. I mean, how will they realize that Emmanuel means God with us? So he's going to be Emmanuel, and he's going to be human.
That's the rumor.
I just don't think they would understand.
Undoubtedly.
And why is he doing this?
To use your words, have you been down there lately?
True.
It's a mess.
Yes, it is.
Anyway, I hear some part of some plan of his.
Oh, I remember. There's the word that was spoken to Isaiah. Let's see if I remember. The Lord himself will send a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to his son, and he will be called Emmanuel.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he will be known as the Wonderful Counselor, the King of Kings. Yes.
Yeah.
The Wonderful God. I mean, Father.
The Prince of Peace.
The Prince of Peace, yes.
Yeah.
And this government will be at peace forever.
Wow. So you think this is that?
Seems like it.
Whoa. So what Gabriel went down there to do makes a lot more sense.
Well, I wonder how it's going to work out, because, you know, down there, everybody has a choice.
Right. You know, I don't know why they wouldn't say yes, though. I mean, sure, he gives everyone a choice to say yes or no, but this has been planned for eternity.
Right.
Those two, they're going to be his lineage there on Earth. I'm pretty sure they're going to say yes. But you're right. They probably won't understand what that entails.
Joseph, who went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, in order to register along with Mary, who was engaged to him and was with child. While they were there, the days were completed for her to give birth, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. And she wrapped him in cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
Understand that the creator of everything is here to be Emmanuel? And they definitely can't see that his fingerprints are on them.
No, they can't see that.
And do they realize what a special night this is? I mean, this is the night that the king of the universe, the seen and unseen, the creator of everything is there, and this night will forever be remembered, and yeah. nothing will ever be the same.
Yeah.
Oh, my dear Savior's birth.
Been outranked.
No. We're not going to tell the king. Anyway,
no, our marching orders are to go down there and meet with the rest of the heavenly hosts, and we're going to announce his arrival to a bunch of shepherds in a field.
Shepherds?
Yeah. Apparently, for some reason, it's important for them to be the first to know.
Huh. Well, I'm glad it's his plan and not mine. So, when are we supposed to make this announcement?
For behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger.
Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill towards men.
Side. Here lay the Savior inside.
now, all is quiet. A star is shining in the sky. Below in Bethlehem, the king is sleeping. Oh, what a glorious night. Oh, what a glorious night.
Well, do you think they got it? I mean, my Hebrew is a little rusty. I mean, time will tell. They look pretty excited. I even think the sheep got it. Yeah, man, I never knew that somebody's mouth could open that wide. I mean, did you see all that drool dripping out? Wait, are you talking about the shepherds or the sheep? Well, I was talking about the shepherds, but them sheep were pretty hilarious, too. It even seemed like they understood what we were talking about.
Yeah, I hope they got it. They seem to be celebrating. Now they'll just spread the word.
When the angels had gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds began saying to one another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem, then, and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they came in a hurry and found their way to Mary and Joseph and the baby as he lay in a manger. When they had seen this, they made known the statement which had been told them about this child, and all who heard it wondered at the things which were told them by the shepherds.
And they are spreading the word. But do you think they really understand what he gave up to come to them?
True. I don't know if they really do understand, you know, that he came here for them. You know, if they could just realize that he came for them.
Yeah, and he would have done it for just one of them.
I know, even if only one ever believed in him.
Yeah, talk about love. You know, my turn. He is the only perfect one. That's why we forget lines. Oh, You know, I heard that this was his plan from the beginning.
The beginning, beginning?
Yeah, the beginning, beginning. Looks like some of them got it. Now let's just hope they pass the message on to everyone else.
Yeah, it will be interesting. You know, I don't know what his perfect, I don't know what his plan is, but I know it's perfect. And I sure hope I get to see some of it myself.
Oh, me too. I can't even imagine, but I can't wait to see it myself.
Yeah, but I wonder, how's he going to make his perfect plan work with imperfect humans? I mean,
yeah, I don't know. I mean, if they could just realize it, if they could, you know, only grasp that he is the creator of everything. You know, the King of Kings.
Yeah. The beginning and the end.
The yes. Alpha and Omega. The seen and unseen.
The Lion of Judah.
The Prince of Peace.
The Risen Savior.
Oh, yes. His most precious title. But
I wonder what that means, risen Savior?
Yeah, I wonder that too. But I'm sure as his perfect plan folds out, we're going to find out.
Because he is perfect.
Yes, he is.
Because he is truth.
He is love.
The great I am.
The creator of everything, seen and unseen.
The king of the universe.
Emmanuel!
Yes,
he is God with us.
And now he is God with all of them.
At the beginning of time, Jesus, the creator of everything, seen and unseen, made a perfect plan to come and be Emmanuel for you. Yes, even you. This Christmas, you are not alone. God is with you. Our God, Emmanuel, author of the perfect plan, is an awesome God, worthy to be praised.
Away in a manger, your crib for us.